एमसीक्यू ऑन प्रोटीन एनर्जी माल न्यूट्रिशन और पीईएम। सो बेसिकली प्रोटीन एनर्जी माल न्यूट्रिशन इज ए कंडीशन रिजल्टिंग इन लैक ऑफ एनर्जी एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ इनएडिक्वेट सप्लाई ऑफ सेवरल माइक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड ऑल मैक्रो न्यूट्रिएंट्स व्हिच कुड आइदर अकर ग्रेजुअली और एज ए सडन चेंज। सो is a condition where you will find that there is a inadequate, insufficient or kam supply ho raha hai kiska na micronutrients or macronutrients like glucose, protein, fats, macronutrients like vitamins, minerals. So all these are supplied in inadequate supply means less quantity. How much ever the requirement is there, the supply is less than the requirement. So after that, what are the different conditions faced by the child, that is discussed, or that is completely called as protein energy malnutrition. It's an important questions which come in various exams from food safety officers, state level or center level, all everywhere you will find like these questions. So PEM can be classified into primary PEM and secondary PEM. So we can solve some MCQ here. So protein energy malnutrition corresponds to a state where the infant's dietary intake is deficient in what? It is deficient in both protein and carbohydrates. Proteins, overall protein calories and carbohydrates. Or the right answer is what? B and C means overall calories and proteins. So ultimately, carbohydrate is also supplied in less quantity, but you can say overall calories and proteins are not supplied completely, or it is supplied in deficient amount. So right answer is B and C. Then the availability of proteins and energy and inadequate absorption in the body is known as what? That is called protein energy malnutrition only. Okay, PEM, that is the right answer is C. Then PEM is mostly seen and has the most destructive consequences in when? Infancy and in childhood. You'll find the problem in infancy and early childhood, because you'll see that during the childhood only different kinds of growth is there, like brain development and other different developments are going on during the childhood times. And in that time, agar wo time mein properly energy or protein body ko nahi milega, to proper growth nahi ho payega. So that's a major problem during infancy and in early childhood. So here our right answer is what? C, that is infancy and early childhood. Then up to the age of 6 months, this is the ideal food for newborns and young infants. See, up at the age of 6 months means the child is just 6 months old, and he that or she needs what? Breastfeeding or breast milk is required. So right answer is C, because you can see that in the infants don't have proper systems or proper digestive systems which can digest complex foods what we can eat, what the adults people can eat. Like the digestive system is not developed in childhood in infants. So kya hoga na, unko keval breast milk hum de sakte hain, kyunki wo milk fully सिंपल फॉर्म में रहता है. ओके, तो वो इजीली डाइजेस्ट हो सकता है किसका? किसके अंदर ना, इन्फेंट्स के अंदर। सो हमको केवल ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग ही देना पड़ेगा और ब्रेस्ट मिल्क ही देना पड़ेगा। देन डिसऑर्डर्स रिलेटेड टू न्यूट्रिशन इज नोन एज व्हाट? एनी डिसऑर्डर्स दैट इज कॉल्ड माल न्यूट्रिशन डिसऑर्डर्स। आइदर दिस काइंड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन यू कैन से दैट disorders means either you can say it is over nutrition or under nutrition, it's called disorder. So malnutrition is termed for this disorders of nutrition. Malnutrition is what? Over nutrition or under nutrition, both are considered in malnutrition, where there is a problem in proper assimilation of nutrients or proper supply of nutrients in the digestive tract. Then the right answer is D. Which of the following diseases is caused by protein energy malnutrition? So generally what kind of disease you will find? It is marasmus. Okay, so right answer is C. We will discuss about marasmus in this lectures later on. Then a newborn infant as part of a routine is immediately assessed with these procedures after delivery. So we do what? APJAR scoring systems. What we do? APJAR scoring system. In that APJAR is a tool. It is a tool to use. It is used to evaluate a newborn's health. Ek naya bachcha jo पैदा हुआ है उसका हेल्थ के बारे में हम इवेल्यूएट करते हैं बाय द हेल्प ऑफ APJAR टूल्स। इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ 5 क्राइटेरिया लाइक अपीयरेंस। अपीयरेंस मतलब क्या? ए से क्या होता है? अपीयरेंस। अपीयरेंस कैसा है? वो दिख रहा है, वो ज़्यादा मोटा दिख रहा है या ज़्यादा पतला दिख रहा है, उसका पेट ज़्यादा बड़ा है, ऐसा कुछ अपीयरेंस उसमें देखा जाता है। देन पल्स, उसका जो हार्ट रेट है उसका हार्ट रेट कितना है, हाउ how fast or how slowly that heart is beating, that is also one criteria. That P is P for pulse. Okay, pulse. Then grimace is what? It is the appearance of the child, how the child is feeling, whether the child is feeling some pain or his eyes or nose or his facial expression, how, whether the child is facing some internal problem, internal pain, then that is called what? Griming. G for griming. Okay, then what? A is for activity. What are the different activity that child is doing? That is activity. Then respirations, R for respirations. Okay, what is the oxygen level, all these things, whether the child is going through some breathing problems, what different conditions. So APJAR scoring systems is carried out after the child is in newborn state. The right answer is B, APJAR scoring systems. Then finally, ketone urea is a genetic disorder impairing the metabolism of what? Is a amino acids phenylalanine. This phenylalanine is not properly digested. Phenylketone urea is a genetic disorder impairing the metabolism of phenylalanine. Okay, so the right answer is what? A is the right answer. It's a genetic disorders, and this genetic disorders is carried from the parents. So it is gene defects is there. Okay, then this can be first indication that PEM has led to the permanent damage to the brain. What you can see that there is a permanent damage to the brain. This you can recognize by considering the circumference of the head. If the circumference of the head is very low the circumference is less, then you can say there is a damage, a permanent damage in the brain, which is caused due to protein energy malnutrition. Okay, so the right answer is C. Then the type of nutrients in which more nutrients are consumed than the required quantity for normal growth of the body is called what? The type of nutrients in which more nutrients are consumed than the required quantity for normal growth of the body is called over intake of nutrients, or we can say over intake nutrients. That is right answer is what? C is the right answer. So it is called over nutrients. Then little bit some questions from marasmus and quasi-occur. A severe form of malnutrition, marasmus occurs when there is a lack of energy and nutrition, when one fails to fulfill the basic requirements. Basic requirement of what? The energy. It causes wasting or the loss of muscles and body fat. So in marasmus, usually what happens, there is a loss of muscles between the bones and the skin. So there is very less muscles between bones and the skin. So that is also called wasting of the muscles. Okay, so the question is, which disorders are kids of age below 1 year more likely to suffer from if breastfeeding is replaced by foods low in calories and proteins? Where the breastfeeding is replaced with what? Foods with low calories and proteins. Then what will be the disease? The disease will be marasmus. Just we have discussed marasmus. Then the deficiency of protein alone is a system of what? Quasi-occur. It is called, the deficiency of protein is called quasi-occur. Then this is a features of marasmus and not quasi-occur. So voracious appetite is a features of marasmus. Okay, then marasmus is not characterized by what? That is a impaired growth in the marasmus, but there is no swelling of limbs. You will not find that there is a swelling of limbs, but you will find replacing tissue proteins, impaired growth, protein deficiency. But this swelling of limbs is not the characteristics of marasmus. Swelling of limbs is generally called as what? Edema. Common name for swelling of limbs, edema. Then next question, there is a considerable decline in the weight of the body and growth rate along with the mental faculties getting impaired. Which of these diseases are associated with the mentioned symptoms? So which diseases are considered? That is marasmus. Okay, it is called marasmus where there is a mental growth rate is affected, mental growth is also impaired, okay, and weight is also affected. All these things are affected in what? Marasmus. Then the right answer is D. This is a common features of quasi-occur and marasmus: thinning of limbs, failure of developments of brain and growth, wasting of muscle. So all these are right. Thinning of limbs, correct. Failure of developments, these are two common symptoms of this quasi-occur and marasmus. So all of the above is the right answers. Okay, then which is not a vitamin deficiency disease? So you see, marasmus is not a vitamin deficiency disease, but you will see this psilosis, scurvy, rickets are due to what? Loss of vitamin, means in deficiency of vitamins. But marasmus is deficiency of what? Energy, protein and energy. So right answer is D. Then if a protein deficiency is seen in a child more than a year old, it may lead to What? Quasi-arcs. C. The right answer is C. Then, pick the correct statement about marasmus. Correct statement of about marasmus. Pregnancy in lactation period. Protein-rich diet replaces mother's milk. So, if you do what? Protein-rich diet is replaced with mother milk. Mother milk is essential. And if you are replacing protein-rich diet, then what will happen? There is a chance of marasmus. Okay. Then last questions. Extensive edema, fat underneath skin, swelling of parts of body are associated with what? These all are associated with what? Quasi-arcs. So right answer is what? Answer is right. Answer A is right. So thank you a lot.